What's up, everyone? Welcome to the Power Play with CJ Prospect Profiles. Today, we're going to be focusing in on Kelowna Rockets forward and 2013 draft eligible player Miles Bell from, like I said, the Kelowna Rockets, a Calgary native. He used to play for the Regina Pats, so we'll get into that in a second. This is his third go round being eligible for the draft. He was not ranked in the mid season rankings by Central Scouting, but as of today, he's the 46th ranked prospect. Moved to forward from defense this season, and had a great year and had 93 points in 69 games. It was plus 46 on a pretty good Kelowna team. Then had 8 points in 7 playoff games for them. So a very talented kid. And then talk about him being undrafted in the past. He was going to be a top 20 prospect in the 2011 NHL entry draft. Got into a car accident. He was 17. Alcohol was involved. He was injured, and the passenger was a young girl, and she died. And he had to do 2 years probation, and really set back his hockey career. He got traded from Regina. He was actually an assistant captain that year with the Regina Pats at 17, which is impressive. And he had 45 points in 66 games a year as a defenseman, and I believe he won the hardest shot competition in the Western Hockey League at 98 miles an hour. So that's what you're looking at. This kid can rip it. Bottom line is, went to Kelowna, had a pretty good year last year. It was minus 18, though. And then this year, really stepped it up a notch. The position change, a la Brent Burns. Although Brent Burns went from forward to defense. I know he's playing forward now, but with San Jose. But he was a forward in juniors and got moved to defense by Jacques Lemaire. Another great move. But story for another day. And like I said, you don't want to make light of the girl, of the young woman that died. But I think Bell has matured since then. And I think you're getting him, he's going to be 20 in August, 13th of August. And so he's more mature than your average player in the draft. He's gone through a lot. And it's almost like the Danny Heatley incident where, you don't want to make light of Snyder's death. But, Heatley came out more mature. And, I don't even like using that terminology. But he's gone through a lot. He's come a long way, in the growing up process. And I think you're getting a guy that will be, well-rounded as an individual in the locker room, and great intangibles, I think. And I like his game a lot offensively. I think he's got the there's a great argument in hockey news with Oliver Ekman-Larsson played a little center when he was 15, and how it's helped him see the ice a few different ways. I think that's what you're getting with Bell, in that he's played defense. I'm assuming he's going to draft him as a forward. That would be, my thing. But so he can see the ice a few different ways. Through that, can help his defense through cutting back and making himself available for breakout pass, stuff like that. So I think he's gonna be good in that regard. And he's a very intriguing prospect, and I can see a team taking a flyer on him in the third or fourth round. And I think he's obviously AHL eligible, and next year he's AHL eligible because he'll be 20. And I think he's gonna be a great player for years to come. And I think he's learned from his mistakes, and he's gonna be a much more mature individual than, and there's gonna be detractors a whole way along for him, but I think that's the nature of the beast, and I'm rooting for the kid. Hopefully he does some great things. Anyway, that's all this episode of the Power Play with CJ Prospect Profiles on Kelowna forward Miles Bell. Stay tuned for more episodes throughout the season and beyond. Later, guys.